Hey everyone, this is Jane with Barlow Herbal and happy Sunday, October 22nd of 2023. Now, I had a fun little exercise I did this week where I wanted to think up a few things that I could do to get myself out of like a mental funk, a physical funk, but things that I could do immediately. So I came up with a list of 10 things at the first of the week as I was sitting there journaling, and I wrote them down. And then at the end of the week, I kind of reassessed, are all of these things that I could share that would immediately pull me out of either like a slight mental depression or funk, or even where I wasn't just feeling that great physically. So the first list I wrote on Monday, and I think that these things will take you through this week and beyond really beautifully. But the first thing I wrote was to stay hydrated. I think that when I'm feeling a little bit under the like weather, like as far as not like sick, but if I'm feeling kind of down, when I drink a big glass of water, and my choice of a big glass of water is typically a quart jar. I just love the size. I love the way I feel when I drink the whole thing. And many people can't hydrate that fast if they're not used to drinking that large amount of water. And this can take a little bit of getting used to if you're not used to drinking a lot of water and staying hydrated. So start with a smaller glass, start with a cup. But a lot of times I find if I simply take a minute and I hydrate, it can bring me out of the way I feel physically and definitely the way I feel mentally. Our bodies are 70% water and our brain is a ton of that. So if we're feeling in a bit of a funk, hydrating can make almost an immediate difference. So the goal of this list is things that can make an immediate difference. So hydration. Number two is deep breathing. I know that sometimes when I catch myself in a place of intense concentration, or I'm doing something and I'm starting to feel kind of like, oh, not 100%, all I got to do sometimes is remind myself to take a deep breath. And if you've ever done intentional breathing, and just even guided breathing, that is actually one of my favorite. When I'm in a group setting and we're doing breath work, and even doing breath work on my own can immediately get me out of a little bit of a mental depression, and definitely it can lift my spirits in a physical way. There are actually breath work apps that you can download on your phone, and when you need a pop of mental clarity, a pop of physical clarity, turn on a breath work that might take 2 minutes, 3 minutes, and you will feel better immediately. I love that one. Stretching. Now this one is really good, especially for people who spend a lot of time sitting. If you have a sitting job, if you have a job, or even, you know, the evenings where you're just spending all evening sitting and you kind of just feel yourself in a bit of a funk, stand up, stretch. Bring your arms above your head, bend to the right, bend to the left, you know, bend down and touch your toes, you know, do all these things, stretch your body a little bit. Immediately, you will feel better. I love that one. That one makes a huge difference for me. Eat a nutritious snack. You might be feeling physically lethargic or mentally lethargic because you might need some food energy. And this can immediately pick up your mood. And the nice thing is you need to really think about what am I eating that's nutritious. You know, don't grab a donut. You might feel good for 10 minutes and then you'll crash, and or you'll want another donut. You know, back when I used to eat donuts, which I went through a big period of time in my 20s and half of my 30s, where I loved fast food, I loved junk food, I loved donuts, and I would go and eat 6 donuts if I, you know, felt so inclined. I would make a trip to the grocery store on purpose to go get some junk food to simply make myself feel better. Now, luckily, I've way outgrown that, but when you eat a snack or you eat something, make sure that it's nutritious. And we all know what that can be, because for some of us, it might be a little bit different. You know, a healthy snack for one person might not be a healthy snack for another person if there's allergies or whatever. Even just your taste buds, right? Get some sun. Now this will immediately lift you out of a depression, a mental or even a physical funk, is getting some sun. quick exercise. This is number six of what I wrote down. Get some quick exercise. You know, walk up and down the stairs. When my sister and I were at the retreat a couple of weeks ago in Florida, during one of the small breaks, we went out and we walked up and down and around the stairs a few times because we did a lot of sitting at this retreat. And while there was some breaks and there was some guided meditation, there was not a lot of physical movement. And there, it was very mentally stimulating, but sometimes what we have to do is we have to stand up and move our physical body. So get some quick bursts of exercise. Doesn't have to be anything that even works up a sweat, right? Number seven, short meditations. Sometimes simply close your eyes, step away from your screens, whether it be your phone, your iPad, your computer, the TV, whatever it is. Step away, sit somewhere quiet, close your eyes. Even 2 or 3 minutes can make a huge difference. Social connections. You know, to me, this one, we don't put enough emphasis on. You know, schedule to have a lunch with somebody. If you're feeling like in a serious mental or physical funk, reach out to somebody that you love and you miss and see if they can meet you for lunch the next day. You might not be able to socially connect with them right away. Send someone you love a text and tell them, I love you, I'm grateful for you, which actually leads right into the next one, which is gratitude. You find yourself feeling mentally or physically down, what will immediately pull you out of that is when you bring out the gratitude. We hear this all the time, it's because it's true. And then the last one on this that I wrote is to do yourself a favor, do a digital detox. Step away from the technology. Step away from all your digital products. You know, this is easier said than done, I know, and we're so used to that dopamine hit that it's very, very hard to disconnect. We actually think it makes us feel better. We think it's gonna bring us out of the funk if we keep scrolling social media and all of that. So these are the first 10 things I wrote at the first of the week. And as I was going through the week, by the time I got to Saturday, which was yesterday, I thought, okay, I'm gonna reassess. So I looked at the list and then I actually ended up writing a second list, which got tweaked a little bit, but there was a lot of the same stuff in it. So the first one, of course, stayed the same, and that is to stay hydrated, drink plenty of water. Now remember, this is a list of 10 things that will immediately help you feel better mentally and physically. The second thing I wrote down here is to breathe deeply. The third thing is to stretch. The fourth thing is to not only meditate, but make them mindful. If you have 60 seconds, close your eyes, step away from your computer, stand by a window, step outside, and for 60 seconds or a few minutes longer, have a mindful meditation. That one is so important. Eat a healthy snack, move your body, disconnect, and then I added this one in, positive affirmations. You know, remind yourself of all the beautiful things that make you you, and affirm them. You know, this is a kind of a self-care, self-love thing. And also remind yourself that these moments of maybe depression or moments of feeling less than or not feeling that good, these two shall pass, right? We just need to put some of these little steps in, or even one or two things to help us get out of that immediately. And then I added here, this actually made the list this time, is engage in a hobby. You know, this always makes me feel better. And it might not be something that you can do in like a 60 second meditation, but this is something that you can disconnect from all your technology, and you can maybe spend the evening writing, drawing, painting, bowling, you know, whatever. Get yourself into your hobby. And if you don't have a hobby, start looking at things that interest you and get yourself a hobby. It can be anything. Everybody's different. Everybody has different things they love. And then the last one, which made the list last time, is to connect with someone. You know, connect with your fellow humans, and connect with someone that you have that connection with, someone who really sees you. To me, that is a really beautiful way to walk through this world. And then a couple of the things that kind of came through to me was to smile even if you don't feel like it. this can help lift your mood like quickly, almost immediately. You know, if you are in a workspace and you need to get up and go to the bathroom and you walk past a few people at their desks or whatever, wherever you are, if you're going to lunch and the person who's taking your order, whatever, smile, be more friendly. This will immediately lift your spirits and lift your mood. And then what I really love is if you have a commute, turn it into you time, like me time. Make this the place where you maybe listen to a favorite podcast. Make this a place where you listen to a book that you've been wanting to listen to. You know, I just got done listening to the biography of Elon Musk on Audible. And that's a big, thick book. This to me feels like total indulgence because I tend to read books that are a little more learning, hardcore, nutrition, herbal, personal growth, all those things, which require me to use a lot of brain power. And it's stuff that I love. But when I indulge in like a biography or even a work of fiction, that feels like just pure disconnection and enjoyment for me. And I loved every bit of it. So I really just wanted to bring you this quick list because it feels like over the last few months, I've mostly had these kind of heavy-like topics. And I'm not an expert in any of these topics. These are just things that I hear about. They're things that that resonate with me. And I mostly want to kind of give you my own spin on them, my own experience with them. And I always love reading what you write in the comments because it really shows the beautiful differences in all of us and some of the things that people get that are different perceptions than mine, I think are really, really important. So this week, I just wanted to bring you some very quick tips that you can use to get you out of a mental or a physical bit of a low point in your life. So I'd love to hear which one resonated most with you. Is there something that you feel like you can do right away that would make a big difference? I would love to hear yours. So thanks so much for tuning in today, guys. I hope you have a brilliant Sunday and a wonderful week, and we'll see you next time.